five designers put Swarovski genuine gemstones on display. And then about a month and a half from now, we'll choose JCK's new rock star.
The judges are a manufacturer, retailer, and you're looking at the journalist.
Guys, I got the stone.
Yes.
I developed two ideas. My first idea was my barbed wire collection.
You could develop it.
Not really, no.
Second part?
Shoot.
Swarovski genuine gemstones, marcasite, and created stones. As infinite and inspiring as your imagination.
Do I feel pressure? I think it's what's stronger than pressure? Crush? Yes.
So I was making this stone shape. Then I realized I can make a ring like that, having a stone in every corner.
How are you going to use color in here?
Maybe just white. Keep it as clean as it gets. So these are my two ideas.
They're so different. Barbed wire symbolize prison. But her other idea was much better.
It's not very impressive.
She's not kidding around.
It's not something that you put on a table and everybody go, wow.
It's not about glamour. It's about execution. Definitely think about it seriously.
Yeah, I know what I'm doing right now. I don't know what I'm getting into. My model failed twice. The casting failed. Then my stones didn't fit. Where are my sketches? It's been too much. 3 business days to finish. Don't ask. The time is way too short. There are a few words for this. Roller coaster, very exciting, scary, demanding, but I think I demand of myself to be at my best.
Welcome to the final day. It's all come down to this.
Glad I survived it.
You did. Let me introduce you to our judges. This is Daniel Cohen. He's a member of the executive board of Swarovski, a world-class specialist in jewelry and design. And at the end, we've got Randy Udell-Alper. She's vice president of London Jewelers, a very prestigious retail operation based in Long Island. I'm editor-in-chief of JCK, and I've covered this business for a little over a decade.
So I chose the triangular stole called Tree Light, and I was drawing this shape and again, and thinking, what are they gonna do? And then I decided it actually becomes a shape of the stone. Like, stone is three-sided, the ring will be of three sides. Hmm. And there will be on each side triangular stone. Yeah, I ordered the casting in palladium. Mm-hmm. So it will work with the cleanliness of the look.
She's very structured and methodical.
I loved Nina's presentation.
And I pick up the ring yesterday at 10 in the night. Yeah, it's fresh off the oven. But I'm very pleased, and it's worn the very different ways.
I think I love it most as a pendant.
I love the geometry of it, big and yet so light. I love that she used palladium. Clever.
Blue is paraiba, yellow is honey, and pink, just called pink. But actually it blends well, in my opinion. But you judge.
How would you retail that? What would pricing be?
That's something I never thought. What I spent so far would make it about $900 in wholesale.
Okay.
Probably even less.
I'm sure the short timeline made it difficult, mm-hmm. but I think you took those parameters and you really worked outside the box and you created something entirely new and different.
Thank you.
I like the multi-dimensionality of it. There's probably some more work to go from concept phase.
I loved it as a pendant. I wish there had been more color in it. Is there anything else you'd like to say to us?
No, I'm waiting to see who will be the winner. Will I win? Will I lose? Participation is already being a winner. So many things failed.
I was a little disappointed in the lighting in the room.
It's been almost metaphysical.
I thought, oh my.
It changed. They're all quite distinct.
Difficult decision.
But sort of.